The pins on the LCD display are labeled as ground, VCC, SDA, and SCL. The ground connection we connect to the ground pin on the Uno. The VCC goes to the 5-volt pin on the Uno. The SDA pin is the I2C data that is connected to pin A4. The SCL pin is the I2C clock and that is attached to A5. We need to install an Arduino library for the LCD display. I'm using one called Arduino Liquid Crystal I2C and it's available to download from GitHub. I'll provide the link in the description. Once it's downloaded, open the Arduino IDE. Select Sketch, Include Library, Add.zip Library, then select the zip file that we downloaded. I2C can support multiple devices. Each device has a 7-bit address to identify it. It's not always obvious what the address of the device is, but to find it, we can run an I2C scanner sketch. I'll put a link for it in the description. We just need to upload the sketch to the Arduino. Open the serial monitor and it will display the I2C address of the LCD display. So now we know the address of the LCD and we've installed the library, we can try a simple sketch. In the Arduino IDE, go to File, Examples, under Examples from Custom Libraries, click on Arduino Liquid Crystal I2C Library Master, then click on Hello World. This prints Hello World on the LCD display. The first line includes the wire library. The second line includes the Liquid Crystal I2C library that we installed earlier. On the third line, the I2C address is specified. It's the address that we got from the scanner sketch. And the dimensions of the display is specified on the second and third parameter. The display I'm using is a 16 by 2, which means that it can display 16 characters per line and it has 2 lines. LCD.begin initializes the interface with the LCD display and LCD.print prints to the LCD display. So let's upload the sketch and see what happens. If you want multiple messages showing up one after another, you can use delays in the loop and LCD.clear, which clears the LCD display and positions the cursor on the upper left corner and print for each unique message. Here I wanted a message, I am powered by Arduino, but this message is too long and the Arduino word would be pushed to the far right side of the display and wouldn't appear. So I used LCD.setCursor and change the line to 1, which means the second line on the display. 0 is the first line, so the word Arduino will be printed on the second line. You can also push the message more to the right side by changing this value. So let's upload this code. It works. If the LCD display is not working, you might need to adjust the contrast potentiometer on the back of the display.